Dear viewer, good evening, and welcome to Spotlight. With me tonight, Oakland County Treasurer Robert Whitberg. Robert, welcome again to MEA.
Thank you. I was here last year as well, and it's nice to be here. Thanks for having me.
You're welcome. It's, you know, honestly, by bringing somebody like you, is going to give a lot of information to the community. And that's our goal of that, you know.
To educate those, people,
educate
right?
Educate the people. And that's why we call it informal show. Interviews.
Yeah.
You know, if it's real estate, if it's immigration, if it's politics, if it's a treasurer, all that to inform the people about what's happening. Robert, tell me about yourself. When did you start with Oakland County?
So, yeah, I'm the Oakland County Treasurer.
Yes.
I started July 1st of 2021.
2021.
But I was elected in the presidential election, actually, of 2020.
Exactly.
But it's this obscure law, it's a state law, that it's only the treasurer and only in Oakland
only
County.
Only the treasurer, yeah.
And only
and
Oakland
only
County.
In Oakland County,
yep.
Yeah.
So that the treasurer takes office July 1st instead after that
January.
Election, instead of January 1st. Yeah, so I started in July 1st of 2021.
Okay.
I was actually a state representative before that, so I served for 6 years in the legislature, and I represented like the southern portion of Oakland County, so like Huntington Woods, Oak Park, Ferndale.
Yep. Part of Oakland County.
I'm Oakland County. Born and raised in Oakland County. Went to Berkeley High School. Mm-hmm. Raised in our family here in Oakland County. We live just, you know, right near the Detroit Zoo. Oakland County is my home, and I love it. And my family, you know, my parents are here. My family's all here.
Yes.
So we love it.
Well, that's nice. That's nice. And honestly, Oakland County, is one of the county that rich and their people, not in money, and their people. Representing and respecting all the culture and all the ethnic minorities and all that. It's, and that's why you see in Oakland County there's a huge Middle Eastern community present.
It's a very diverse community.
Absolutely.
A very welcoming community.
Yes.
And there are a lot of communities that thrive in Oakland County. Not everyone. There are, you know, those that have their struggles. And so that's why when, you know, we're trying to help and serve those people, we want to serve everyone in Oakland County and make sure you know, that everyone has an opportunity to thrive in the community. Yeah. But it is a beautiful and diverse community, and that's why I love Oakland County more than anything. You know, I did live out of state for just a little bit. I went to college out of state, but I knew I always wanted to come back here, and specifically Oakland County. It is a wonderful place to live and raise a family and work, socialize. It's just a beautiful place.
Great. You know what? I lived 35 years in West of Bloomfield, and I had many time Chief of Police, Michael, and the administrator, Steve Kaplan.
Yep.
You know, many times, you know, we would bring him here and different places.
Steve's great.
From where, Oakland County, Southfield all the time, Oak Park all the time. We bring usually the Chief of Police and the mayor, and they talk about their involvement and Middle Eastern involvement in that city.
Yeah.
But as a county, it's excellent county. Let's talk about the treasurer.
Yeah.
Okay. Why the taxes come to the treasurer, and when come to the treasurer?
So,
usually I pay the city.
So, okay, that's a great question.
Yes.
People hear this all the time, you know, they get confused.
Yes.
But ultimately how it works is when you pay your current year taxes, you pay it to your local community.
Okay.
Right? So like
the
you in
summer and the winter.
Yep, the summer and the winter. So
okay.
Like right now we're in, you know, March of 2023.
Okay.
So the 2022 taxes
were
due to the local treasurer, and it's usually in February. It's due before the end of March.
Yeah.
And it's due to the local treasurer.
Okay.
As long as you pay it there, you actually never come over to the county treasurer.
I see.
County treasurer comes into play when you're delinquent with your taxes.
For how many years?
So, well, right away. So
if you miss
that first year.
Oh, I see. Yeah.
So like right now, 2023 taxes. So you're going to start to see your 2023 taxes come out, you know, this year.
Okay.
If you don't pay them to your local community, excuse me, then they get passed over to the county treasurer. So in essence, the county treasurer, we buy that debt, if you will, from the local community, right? Because the local community, if a ton of people didn't pay their, you know, their taxes, then the local communities would struggle to provide services. So we have this system in place. We have our DTRF fund. It's the Delinquent Tax Revolving Fund. And we use that fund to, in essence, buy the debt from the local community.
Okay.
And then become the collections agent, if you will. We're the ones that are then charged with collecting the taxes that are delinquent. And this is state, right? This is the way it's
county.
Set up. Every
county
is the same.
Yeah.
This is how it is for the state.
Yeah.
So for us, it comes over to us when they're delinquent.
I see.
Now, you know, what probably the most important thing that people want to know about and hear about is foreclosure, right?
Yes.
That foreclosure process is about a...
We'll come to it.
Okay, all
we'll
right.
We'll come to it. And as you know, Robert, COVID created a lot of problems to a lot of people. A lot of people lost their job, and they're not going to be able to pay the taxes.
Yeah. Okay.
If they don't pay the taxes and came to you as a county treasurer, do you have a plan for them, how to help them, how to guide them? You know, because if he doesn't pay 1 year, let's say $5,000, second year is $5,000 plus interest and all that, it becomes about $17,000, $18,000.
The numbers.
What's the help that you could offer?
So you're right. So, and this is also, this is mandated by the state. So we have no control over this, but ultimately that first year comes over and then you're charged interest of 1%.
You're implementing the law.
Yes, we're implementing the law. That's exactly right. So it's charged of 1% a month is what you're charged. So that's 12% annually.
Wow.
And there are fees that are also added as well. Mm-hmm. And then in that, so that's in the second year. In the third year, it actually is retroactively becomes 18%, so 1.5% every month. So it's a lot. It is high.
Of course,
and it can add up really quickly with all the fees and the interest.
Within 3 years, $5,000 could be $25,000.
I mean, so it can be a lot of money.
Yes.
And so that's why we encourage people, like, you know, don't delay, you know, don't be late paying your taxes. We don't want them to be delinquent, because then you get charged more and you're paying a lot more than you know you should have.
Yes.
And so that number can add up. So what we do is we try to work with people.
Okay.
Right. There's grants available. I know you said, you know, some of the other treasurers were here and they probably talked about it.
Yes.
One of the grants is called the My Half Program. It's the Michigan Homeowners Assistance Fund, so M-I-H-A-F. So if you go online to myhalf.michigan.gov, and it'll be on the screen. I think you'll put it on the screen.
And I think I have this flyer, and, you know, we're going to put it in.
So this program is, it's federal COVID relief dollars that was given to the states, and then MISHDA, the Housing Development Authority for the state, administers this program, and it's up to $25,000 per household. And they can use it for delinquent if they're late on their mortgage, they're delinquent on their taxes, their utility bills, you know, homeowner fees, association fees, up to $25,000.
Yes.
And then the requirements are that the person has to be within 150% of the area median income.
Okay.
And that number's online depending on where you live and how many people are in your household.
Okay. What's the minimum, $50,000?
Minimum for?
For the people who qualified. Oh, to make a year.
I don't know the number offhand. It depends on where your area, where you live.
Oh, I see.
It's 150% of the area median income, right?
I see.
And then it pays on how many people are in your family.
Yes.
But it's up to $25,000 per household to pay for all those. So it's a great program. In Oakland County, we've had, I think, nearly 400 residents in Oakland County who have applied for this, who have gotten over, I think it's now we're over $4 million that has been given to Oakland County residents to help pay those delinquent bills that they have. So it's been a great program.
400 families, they stay under the roof.
That's right.
And I've been talking to you a lot, and your goal and objective is to keep the family under the roof.
Without question. Our priority is, like, a foreclosure is the last resort, right? Like, we want to work with people. I think that's when it boils down to, like, when we talk about what we do in our office is we help. We try to help. And so we want to reach out to people and hear from people to tell them about what options are available to them. We also want to get them on a repayment agreement.
Yes.
But we don't know people need help unless they tell us they need help.
Exactly.
And so they need to reach out to us. So that would be my, you know, my main thrust of what I've been trying to tell people is please reach out to us.
For this program, how they reach you?
So they call us, right? So call 248.
What's the number?
Yep, 248-858-0611, 248-858-0611. Or you go to our website, which is oakgov.com/treasurer. You can go there as well.
Okay.
Oakgov.com/treasurer, 248-858-0611. Call us, go on our website. We actually, we do what are called taxpayer assistance meetings. So these are one-on-one. We do a confidential meeting with you on the phone, or if you want to do it on Zoom, if you want to come into the office, we'll talk to you about your unique situation and how we can be helpful, but we want to help you. But we need you to reach out to us and let us know that you need help.
Great. And I'm sure there is some nonprofit organization, they offer an attorney and advice for free.
Yes, yes.
For free, so they could go to that too.
That's Lakeshore Legal Aid.
Yes.
So Lakeshore Legal Aid is we are not affiliated with them, but we recommend people to go there as well. They're a great nonprofit.
Yes.
They are a free service for low-income families and seniors, and they do everything but criminal law. They do all kinds of law other than criminal law. They are a great organization, so we refer people over there as well.
And they could help them explain everything, how to
absolutely
apply and all that.
Absolutely.
Yeah. But You know, Robert, because of the COVID, for a lot of people, it get from bad to worse,
to worse.
And sometimes they get frustrated, and whatever you send in mail, they don't read it or, you know, through it.
Yeah.
I know this is very important. We have over 250,000 daily viewers.
Yeah.
And we reach. What other tool you use to reach the community?
So we send mail.
Okay.
We send mail to the house. We have multiple letters, right? There's a multiple mail.
In different language?
We don't send it in different language, but we send something that says that we can help you translate it.
Okay, good.
Or to help have someone help you translate it.
Yeah.
We also have personal service to the property. So someone comes out to actually visit the property to see if someone's there, and then they leave information for them. That actually happens twice as well. So before we would foreclose on someone, we will have reached out to them probably 8 to 10 times before they would even be foreclosed. And so we're reaching out to them. 99% of people reach back out to us or make their payments, right? It's a very small percentage, less than like 0.5% of people who we just don't hear from.
Exactly.
And so there are some people who we've had calls where people are like, it was my grandparents' property, I can't afford it anymore, I want to let it go to foreclosure. So that those do happen, that happens from time to time.
And you have to take it.
Yeah, you know? But at the end of the day, right, if someone wants to stay in their property, we want to try to work with them. We, you know, again, we want to be very compassionate, but we also want accountability. We want people, right, because everyone, if everyone's paying their taxes, we want to make sure to keep you up to date as well, but we will get you the help you need to do that.
Good. Robert, if somebody rent the house or apartment or whatever, and he's paying every month the rent, and he doesn't know that the owner, he's not paying the taxes.
Yeah.
And then suddenly there is foreclosure, and he'll tell you, I'm paying my rent every month. So how do you deal with that?
You know, that's a really tricky situation. You know, the city of Detroit, I know, has, and they're unique in this, that they the renter can actually look to get the home, right?
Yes, yeah.
That is a unique program that is just for the city of Detroit. We don't have that set up just because that is a unique program for the city of Detroit.
How you could help them?
Well, it could be, so we don't, you know, if it, again, we don't want to foreclose on them. We want to try to work with them. We actually have gone to, in instances where it's a renter and we can't hear from, we will go to the house, we'll talk to the renter.
He doesn't know because he's paying, he said, I'm in good.
So we'll talk to the person that's there.
Yes.
And try to get the contact information for whoever it is they're paying their bill to, right? They should have some contact with the landlord. Ultimately, if it does happen, we do not evict. That is not something we do. We would hope that whoever does purchase the house would keep them there in the house. But we will try to get them resources or do whatever we can to try to help them.
Okay.
But we are not evicting anyone. We're not trying to take them out of their place.
Yeah. I know your office and your mentality.
Right,
and believe me,
you'll
do everything to keep the family under their roof.
Absolutely.
Because this is the only thing they have in life sometimes.
Yes.
Robert, there's something very important. If somebody doesn't pay, and we're going to come to that rental, he's paying, but the landlord is not paying. March 31st is the deadline for people who doesn't pay foreclosure. Tell me more about it.
Yep, so like I was talking to you about, there's your delinquent taxes, right? So the first year, you don't pay your first year of taxes, then it comes over to the county treasurer, right?
Yes.
You owe them to the local community, you don't pay, it comes over to the county treasurer.
Yeah.
Then in essence, 2 years after that, right, is when you're subject to foreclosure. So right now we're in March of 2023.
Okay.
So March 31st of 2023 is the foreclosure deadline for anyone that owes 2020 or prior year taxes.
2020.
So if you're at home right now and you owe 2020 or prior year taxes, 20, 19, 18, 17, as far back as it might go.
Okay.
If you don't pay that this year by March 31st, you will be foreclosed, likely be foreclosed, unless you reach out to us. Unless you reach out to us, and that's when we want to try to work with you. We want to see if there are grants available. We want to get you on a repayment schedule. We want to know that you need help, right? If we don't hear from you, we don't know you need help. But that's it. So it's right now, it's in essence 3 years looking back. So right now, March 31st of this year in 2023, it's any taxes 2020 and prior. Those are subject to foreclosure this year.
If somebody doesn't pay 18, 19, 20, 20, or let's say 18, 19, and 21, but he got brought back to work and all that, they send him the 22, he paid.
Yeah.
And he think he's current. He think he did the job. You know, they forgot about 19.
Yeah.
How are you gonna let them know? Because he still tell you, I paid 22, look at it.
Yeah. So that's, part of the statute, right? What we're required to do, those are the letters. So they will be notified many, many different times, right? So we send certified mail to them.
Okay.
We send regular mail to them.
Although you pay 22, but you still owe.
We send them a bill that shows, yes, like, you paid this, but you did not pay this.
Oh, and the bill, it's showing.
It will show it, absolutely.
Oh, I see. Good, yeah.
Yes, so they know, right, what they've missed.
I see.
And so we want to work with them to try to get caught up on those taxes.
Okay, so March 31st, if somebody doesn't pay, what are you going to do?
If they haven't paid,
yeah,
and they have not reached out to us,
exactly.
So ultimately, you know, we look at it, and so we'll look and see, right? Is someone living in the property? Again, we have someone who visits the property
good.
And makes a note,
good.
Right?
Yeah. Uh-huh.
And so we, before that deadline, right, we will do everything we can to reach out to someone.
Please.
And if someone is living there, we will go knock on the door.
And we're going to repeat this interview 3-4 times,
yes,
because it's very important.
Yeah. Well, yeah. I will encourage people, reach out to us, because if we hear from you, then we will withhold it from foreclosure as long as we can have that conversation of how we can help you.
I see.
But if we never hear from someone, right, like I said, there's some people that just want to let their house be foreclosed because either they don't live there,
yeah,
or it was a family member's. But there is, you know, foreclosure
or a rental.
Yeah.
He doesn't know.
Yep.
You know.
Yep.
So
that's why we are reaching out to the community. We actually will go visit the property in person.
Yes.
To tell people, like, you need to reach out to us, or we need to talk to you before March 31st.
Okay.
So it can happen, you know, because there are foreclosures. Thankfully, last year, like when we did foreclosures last year, out of the thousands and hundreds of thousands of parcels in Oakland County,
yes,
there were only 374 parcels that were foreclosed upon, and I would say nearly 90% of them were vacant.
Wow. Well, honestly, when we did the interview with Eric Sobrey, Wayne County Treasurer, on a Friday, Monday, because they know our number.
Yeah.
Monday, we had about 8-9 calls, and we give them the phone number.
Yeah.
And they call.
Yeah.
You know? So hopefully with this, we're going to put the phone number and all that. Okay.
Please call. Yes.
Sure. The deadline is March 31st. When is the foreclosure?
So March 31st is that foreclosure date.
I know, but when they're going to take over and do the auction?
Okay, so March 31st is foreclosure, right?
Okay.
Then they're foreclosed.
Okay.
But, you know, and like we said, we don't evict anyone. So if someone is still there, they're not going to be evicted.
Okay.
But what happens is it goes through that process, and then there is a land sale where it goes, and this is, again, required by statute. So there's a land sale that will happen in the summertime.
When?
Usually late summer. We don't have the date set yet, but like last year we did it in August.
Okay.
We'll likely do it in August again this year.
Okay.
So there's the sale in August, and then there's a second sale in September.
Okay.
October. I think we did in October. So it was August and then October.
I think Wayne County, he mentioned October.
Yep.
Okay. And I asked Eric, but I'm going to ask you the same.
Okay.
Probably could be different and all that. Somebody doesn't pay by March 31st. And then on April, he's got a new job and all that. Can he pay it in April or May before the auction?
So once they missed the deadline, they missed the deadline, unfortunately. But that's why in that situation, if someone reaches out to us and says, listen, I'm having a hard time, but I'm applying for jobs. Please, can you help me? We can help you before March 31st.
I see.
That's why this is so important.
Yeah.
This is why it's so important. We're telling people you have to reach out to us before March 31st. Because
as long as he reached you, you could do probably in April or May, or
we can do a repayment agreement.
Find a way to help him.
We can do a repayment agreement. But that's why March 31st, and that's why I'm doing a robust campaign on TV, obviously trying to speak to all of you, in newspapers, online.
It's important, very important.
So we need people, because, you know, if someone comes to us after March 31st, right, we have done, like I said, we have sent numerous letters to their house. We have had at least 2 visits to their property specifically, and literally posting something on their door that says, please call us, right? So we're doing all this outreach, and so we just need you to reach out to us.
Okay, another question. When you put in an auction, can the person who owned the property, can he go and buy it? Can he go and bid? Because he's got a job now, he's got money
right
now.
Right.
Yeah.
So it's a good question. I don't know offhand. I don't know if you're prohibited if you're the owner, but what changed in the law now is that if you were an owner or you had some kind of interest in the property, now what happens is you fill out a claim form, and if the property does sell, whatever it sells for above and beyond what was owed, right? So the interest, the fees, the taxes, everything that was owed, whatever it sells for above and beyond that is called surplus. That surplus, they are entitled to the surplus. So a judge does that. We don't actually do that, but a judge then rules on that. It's like a case with a judge. And if it sells for, you know, above and beyond, they are
the taxes
eligible.
Are much
they're,
they owe, yeah.
they're eligible to get yeah. whatever the surplus is.
Yeah. Is that doesn't including their mortgage and all that?
So mortgage is separate, right? Everything we do is
you
just
pay
tax related.
The taxes, and then you could have the house.
Yeah. So mortgage foreclosure is very different, right?
Yeah.
Ours is taxed, like we said, it's
oh,
a three-year
yeah. but
three-year
the
process.
People, you know.
Right, right. So
yeah.
at home, I'm telling people, right?
Yes.
So three-year process for the taxes.
Taxes.
Mortgage, right?
Uh-huh.
It's a lot quicker. I don't know the number, but like yes. if you, you know. Default on your mortgage
payment,
and over three,
yeah.
4, 5 months, whatever, the company yes. will have some kind of terms. That's when they can foreclose on you. And their mortgage foreclosures are very different. They
yes.
give you a little different timeline to redeem.
Yeah.
For ours, once you get that, because you know ours, the time is built on the back end. So it's that 3-year process. And we try to reach out to you as much as possible. Once you hit that March 31st deadline, you're not able to redeem.
I see. Let's go back again, because those people, I care about them. The renter, because
yeah.
they're paying.
Yes.
If the house goes for an auction, can the rental buy? And I believe in Wayne County, they're doing that.
That's what
are
they
you
do.
Doing that?
So that's what you're talking about,
yes.
right? That's the program that they have.
Yes.
But they actually, what happens is the city does like the first right of refusal.
Okay.
And they buy it before it actually goes to the
exactly.
auction.
Exactly. Yeah.
And then that person can then turn around and buy it from them.
The rental.
Yes.
He could be owner of the house.
Correct. Yeah. I forget the name of the program. Maybe Eric mm-hmm. talked about it, but they have a program. We do not right now have that program. I'm under the understanding that was actually designed specifically for the city of Detroit. There was legislation that enabled them to do that based on the size of the city, which uh-huh. Detroit was the only one that fell under that. So ours, but they could at the auction, right? Yes, they could absolutely bid at the auction.
I see. Of course, you're not going to know if the people, they're not paying and all that, if they are Jewish or Middle Eastern or Polish or Latino.
No.
But in general, I'm talking now about the Middle Eastern community, and there's good percentage. Do you think there's a good percentage that they're not paying the property, the taxes, and their property go foreclosure?
So I really couldn't.
You're not gonna know. I know.
I don't, but I can just say, right, in Oakland County
yes.
as a whole, right, we are a prosperous county, I think
yes.
is probably the best way to describe it.
Absolutely.
But not everyone, right? There are those people that are having their issues.
Especially through COVID, what happened in COVID.
Especially through COVID.
Yeah.
So, but when we look at the numbers, right, again, how I said that you owe your taxes to the local community your
mm-hmm.
first year,
yes.
and then it comes over to us that second year if you have not paid it. Only 4% of taxpayers in the county
yeah.
ever come over to us.
Wow.
96% of people pay their taxes to mm-hmm. the local community before
yes.
the deadline
yeah.
and don't go delinquent. So we only see 4% that ever come delinquent, and then that number winnows down
from there.
What's
that 4% by number? How many?
Oh, I actually don't know that offhand. I would have
yeah.
to let you know.
Okay.
But yeah, but it's low, right?
It's
I mean,
low. It's not too
it's low. And then, like I said, once you get to the foreclosure number,
mm-hmm.
the foreclosure number is like less than 0.5%. I mean, it is small.
I see. Well, we're gonna invite you again to talk about the auction.
Sure.
And how people could. But if you have a few words now to talk about it,
the auction itself.
Yeah.
So obviously our goal is not to foreclose.
Yes.
Our goal is to help people and keep them in their property.
Uh-huh.
But foreclosure does happen.
Okay.
And so we actually do an auction. We do a live auction online.
Oh, that's
good. So it's
good.
Online.
Yeah. Okay.
And
do you know when is that going to happen?
It'll likely in August. We
okay.
don't know the exact date
okay.
yet. We'll schedule that.
I see.
But it's online. The company we work with actually has, they do it for 72 of the 83 counties in Michigan.
Wow.
So it's not even
so
just ours. So people go on there.
Yeah.
They're experienced. People
yeah.
that are looking for property can look all across the state.
Okay.
But we put them on there, and it doesn't cost taxpayer money. Cost taxpayer money to put it on.
I
the
see.
Buyer actually pays a like a percentage fee on top of whatever they purchase.
I see.
That's part of it. So it's built in. But it's a great program so that people can you know bid from anywhere.
Yeah.
And like I said, last year it was predominantly vacant land. My guess is it'll
is
be
it
the same.
Is it residential and commercial?
It's residential and commercial.
Yes.
It's mostly residential and mostly vacant.
What's the name of the company so we could put it in the website?
So the website, ultimately, if you start looking there, it's tax-sale.info.
Okay. And
so
we're
it's tax-sale.info.
Yeah, and we're going to, you know.
You can put that information. So that's where they do all their auctions.
Yes. Finally, honestly, you're doing a very good job reaching to the community, and you believe, I'm very strong, that community, any family there is nothing more important than that house.
Absolutely.
And you believe in it.
I absolutely believe it.
Thank you so much for that.
Yeah.
Any message, even 1 minute, to the Middle Eastern community?
Yeah.
Okay, from Oakland County Treasurer?
Yeah, I would say that we are here to help. You know, that's the one thing I always try to tell people is we do not discriminate. We believe that everyone has worth and value. We want to see everyone thrive in our communities, wherever you are from, whatever your background is, whatever your beliefs are. We want to make sure that you are able to thrive in our community. And we don't want you to be afraid or nervous or embarrassed to call our office. We want you to call our office if you need help. That's the most important thing. And I said this before, I'll say it again. We don't know you need help unless you tell us you need help. So call us, please. And if you need a translator, we have someone in our office.
Yeah.
That can help with that. Or if you have someone in your family, we have phone calls all the time where someone will be calling with their son or their daughter.
Yes.
Their child will be there to help translate as well and talk it through. But please, please, please reach out to us. We are always here to help.
Robert, on behalf of the whole Middle Eastern community, I thank you for your effort, honestly.
Thank you.
It's very important that you're reaching and you're keeping the family under the roof. So thank you again for that.
Yes. Thank you, Wally, for having me, and thank you all for tuning in. And I look forward to coming back again soon.
Absolutely. Dear reviewer, that was my interview with Oakland County Treasurer Robert Whitberg. You heard him. He's trying to help you. He's trying to help you in every way possible. He's trying to reach you. And he is here so you could listen from him, reach from him. I know in the Middle Eastern community, sometimes you feel embarrassed to go to the county treasurer, fearing that the people, they know that you didn't pay the taxes and all that. But losing the house is by far worse. So please go. You could call them, you could visit the website, you could, you know, come to them. There is an attorney, they represent you for a free, and they explain everything for you, and they will solve your problem. Everybody in one time got hardship, okay? But that hardship, and we know through COVID, you got a lot of hardship. But it's almost over, and now you're returning to your work. You started making family. You know, you want to pay your taxes. And don't think if you pay the taxes for 22, okay, you're done. If you don't pay 20 and 90, because you have to pay those. And please reach the treasurer office, the Oakland County Treasurer office, and they'll give you so many ways. They could put you in payment. They could put you with MISHTA, which is paying your utility, your rent, and all that. They help you up to $25,000. And I think most of you guys, the taxes and all, no more than that, no more than $20,000. So it'll give you even another $5,000 to pay utilities and all that, and to help you. They give you a good start, a new start in your life. So please reach them, and we're going to put the phone number, we're going to put the website. Please reach them, because they're there to help you. And I know Robert very well. His mission is to keep every family under the roof. So with this person, with this passion he has, I think you should reach. You should reach so you could take care of your problem. Thanks for watching, and good night.